chairs. So you did a great job with that, and I apologize for this.
Are you ready?
I want to tell you, I am going to introduce Mary. Wonderful award. And that's what we're going to spend some time doing for just a few moments, because you deserve recognition. So the following awards exemplify outstanding character and achievement. Your teachers and I know that even with your parents, all of our best efforts, in the end, no matter what we think, in the end, it is your work that determines how much and how well you learn. When you work to your full capacity, you set goals and you work to the needs, knowledge and skills that enable you to create a future and control your destiny. That's you. And some kids, they started already. And we are proud of them. They are the leaders and the learners in our future. So friends, I am going to introduce a couple awards. The first is called the Presidential Academic Excellence Award. It's fancy, but it's got a long name. It is a national award, and it is intended to recognize academic success in the classroom. I am proud to present this academic honor to the following students, and so when I call your name, I'm going to ask you to come up here. Oh, I want you to meet her families in a few minutes. I'm going to ask you to come on up here. When they call your name, are you ready? I'd like to invite Hunter and Kavish.
Yeah.
often. Indiana Hout. Megan Petrovsky. Lucas Shigami. Yes, I apologize, I killed that one. Maxton Zabel. And Nicola Zarakovich. Now, this award honors student leaders who consistently display a positive attitude towards others, our school, and our community. These students possess a strength of character. They are true leaders who possess the courage to do what is right, even when no one is looking. They are role models to others, and I cannot tell you how much I appreciate all of your help. Thank you, Ron. Thank you, Ron. And I also want to tell you, I cannot tell you how proud I am of all of you and who you are as leaders and learners. Let's give them a round of applause.
And Nicola Rakovich. like sports-wise, to like really get into it, like, ladies and gentlemen! This is not only for people that are great at sports and enjoy being in the gym, which most people do. This is a lot of just respectfulness, responsibility, trying their best. I always tell kids, you don't have to be great at sports. Just give your best effort. Just try your best. And these kids exemplify that. So once again, please stand up when you hear your name. Jacob Ellis. Isaac Zirinowski. Chloe Edwards. Kaylee Mitchell.
Thank you.
stand up. This group of people, boys and girls, were very, very awesome this year. They help people, those kindergartners, those first few days on and off the bus, which is always stressful. They're holding doors open for people. We have several that are post safeties that go out and help, whether that be different people with the flags or the crossing guards. And we had to use them a lot this year, and they did a great job in their role. So give them all a round of applause.
Like service to others, it does make a difference. It makes our world a better place. When you put yourself out there and you try new things like science Olympiad and Lego robotics, it pushes your mind and it pushes others around you. That is what makes a difference. At this moment in life, all of you, Lego robotics, service squad, safeties, and science Olympiad, please stand. Let's face our family.
All have made my first year here very memorable.
Students, I ask you to take this chance to dedicate yourself to making your sixth grade year even better. Remember that you don't have to follow the crowd. Do the right thing, even if no one is looking. Study hard, and remember that you're investing in yourself with every test and that you take and every book you read. And finally, don't be in too big of a hurry to grow up. These are some great times in your life. Don't rush past them. There are great things coming in your future. And just as your parents are proud, each one of you should feel proud of yourself. Good luck in all of your future endeavors, and please remember to come back and visit.
My fellow parents, I'm so glad I'm able to speak to you. As many of you know, I'm a mother of four girls, which, as many of you know, can make life a little extra interesting at night. As parents, we know the last few years have been a hectic at-home learning experience, so I figured I knew what I was getting myself into this year. As a blended support teacher, I was excited to work with a fifth grade team. I was lucky enough to have Ms. Sadowski with my oldest, who's now finishing eighth grade, so I knew that she was great before the year started. I had heard nothing but wonderful things about Mr. Ferguson, and I was glad to learn just how wonderful he is for myself. Mrs. Stefano was new to our school, and I was a little nervous to work with her, but right away, it was obvious just how amazing she is, a perfect fit for the fifth grade team and for Cherokee Elementary. Now let me tell you from personal experience with these three teachers that our students here at Cherokee are loved, cared for, and supported on a daily basis. The personal expectations that each of these teachers has for themselves is inspiring, going above and beyond for each and every student, before and after school, nights, and weekends. I have no idea just how much hard work goes into being a teacher. Curriculum, standards, classwork, online work, streaming, progress reports, report cards, weekly lesson plans, weekly s'mores, class expectations, rewards, seating charts, dojo points, attendance, schedules, there's so much more. These teachers have each dedicated themselves to helping every student be their very best. And I am honored as a mother to have worked with them. Because of their examples, I am a better person. Our children are better, and the world is a better place. Students, you guys are awesome. I'm so excited for you to go to middle school. Enjoy every moment. It will fly by faster than you expect it to. Remember, you are ready. You have the skills and the knowledge that you need to move forward. I am so proud of you and your hard work over the last few years. You and your smiling faces will be missed. We also expect you to come back and visit. Thank you, parents, for trusting us with your children. Thank you, staff, for being so wonderful. And thank you again to the fifth grade team for being truly inspiring. At this time, I'd like to welcome Elise and Jalen.
Rise.
Jacob Allen.
Owen. Yeah. but we're so excited that we made it this far. It is indeed a huge accomplishment for our students to finish elementary school and for our parents and teachers to guide us. And we already have had some more. We still keep our heads up and continue our successful journeys throughout our lives. Your story. The adventure ahead of you is the journey of purpose and potential. Celebrate our hard work through all our years of elementary school. I can't believe we're about to go to middle school after spending so much school time in our home. Thanks, COVID. It was nice having my little brother and my little sister home when she was never before, but it was also a little annoying, if you know what I mean. Oh, trust me, I love you, baby. At the same time, we all from everyone at home, from our parents to our teachers online. Every year has many challenges, but our parents, teachers, and administrators have helped us. On behalf of Ms. Defunco and Ms. Ginter's fifth grade class, we would like to thank our parents, church teachers, and staff for all that you taught us and did for us. It is true what they say, teachers are having staff. Two of my classmates, we have made many fun, silly, and great memories together over the years that we will always share.
Speaking of memories,
hey, you remember the time when we took a test, we told our moms it was GPA, and we were sure we both faced with the perfect score?
Yeah,
we both failed it. And I may never do that again. Anyway, all our fifth grade class had goofy, silly, and crazy memories together, even ones we can all relate to, like the picnic, bowling trip, and walk class.
Yes, Maya, we have made many funny, fun, silly, and great memories together with our classmates. Over the years that we will always share, my two favorite memories were also the picnic and the bowling trip at Imperial Lake.
This is just the beginning, and there are many more chapters waiting for us, starting with middle school.
We would like to finish by saying how excited we are to start a new chapter with all our Cherokee friends and to share our memories, stories, and laughs from our time at Cherokee with our new friends to come to middle school.
And quote, heroes come and go, but legends last forever. Let's all be legendary.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, can you join us with a round of applause for our Cherokee Elementary graduates and our lovely assistant principal?
Jada Bogos.
yourself, but also on the support of your families and your teachers. So I would welcome you to please stand, face your family, face your staff, and let's thank them with a round of applause.
Give me the blue stuff!
wonderful creativity to our school and to our students. So I just want to make sure to recognize him and please give him a round of applause. Up, please, and we're going to have you guys come on down. Give us a class, come on down.